Here we are, another video. Today is Check the Phone, 16th of January, at precisely 1:59 PM. Time to start working on Thunderbird 2. First problem, correct a few little scale issues which are really annoying me, and also try and just make these look a bit nicer and neater and more in keeping with the real model, along with some other little window detail bits around here and just other little needy bits that are really sort of just not getting to me a bit. But yes, we shall go through them, try and sort them out. For the start with, I think I'll just clear them up. The model will clean up all the spruce and the extra little bits that are just flesh, and just file them all down, try and make it look a bit nicer and neater. And if anybody's wondering what I'm using for reference, the answer is these fantastic model pictures by that talented man. So these are the pictures I'm going to use inside the pod. Was going to do that, changed my mind. Oops, not that one. So yeah, Martin Bauer made all the model Thunderbird models for the early 90s for the comic magazine that was out, that most of us collected as kids, I would imagine. Every time you had a brand new action shot of Thunderbird 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, they were his model kits. He is an absolute legend. And I'm using his bases, his models, his pictures, photos, as a basis for this kit. I can only apologise, Martin, I'm not doing you justice at all. I apologise for the lighting, but this is what I just wanted to point out on this model kit. The glowing legs. No. Right, here is the model, how this is doing it. With the bracket bit there, so the legs can fold up, so they go flush with the body, so it would sit down on the ground. On the pod, we have these lovely comedy wheels. So when this, the legs are folded up, it gives enough ground currents for the thing to roll about and be played with happily by youngsters. Well, I'm not doing that. I want this to actually sit nicely and actually look like it did in the show. Flat on the ground, international rescue here to save the day. So, right, first thing to do, lose the comedy wheels. Here comes our problem. Now, the height clearance Thunderbird 2 actually had with the pod was the pod never actually left the frame of the bodywork. So technically the pod should be about there somewhere. I mean, the only time it ever left it completely was when it dropped it in the ocean for Thunderbird 4. So we need to do quite a little bit of modding on these poxy leg bits to get the height right, which is very easy to do. I'm just going to take these bits out and the peg that goes in those, so you can fold it up. I'm just going to shave it down so it fits in the owl, and then just shave a little bit off the bottom of the feet, which are the wrong shape as well, but we're not going to split hairs on the entire model, otherwise I'll end up hitting it with a ruddy hammer. Well, there we go, with the legs pegs shaved down and so they fit better in the hole. So it's a little bit lower than a pod, almost correct. The only trouble now is there's no sort of stability in it, so I'm going to have to really sort of make sure they're glued straight and wibble, wibble, wibble. Otherwise, Thunderbird 2 looks like she's been on the booze. Hang on, I've just realised. I was looking at these legs thinking, hang on, I know these from Thunderbirds, but they're not Thunderbird 2. It's the bloody Sidewinder.
Fall down a hole now they're all stuck.
Right, that's it for this video. So it's gonna be only gonna have to be short and sweet, because something else has come along and got in the way. Namely work. Yeah, well, took a bit longer than I anticipated on this one. But anyway, one side, I know they're not quite square yet, but once I've sanded down the inside a bit better and made it smooth with the bodywork, the interior, should be quite cool. Windows, the other side, Yep, the holes have been made ready to file it down and just smooth it all out. Better than those plastic holes that were there. And then what I'm going to do is just put like a small piece of plastic bent along the curved over the inside of the bodywork just to give the windows. I might frost them up or just spray it black on the inside just to give that glazed look and the dark parts of the ship. And that's pretty much it for the base of Thunderbird 2. Let's sit over there. As for the top, I've used the masking tape just to give me a rough idea of how big the windows need to be in comparison to the rest of the ship, which is about that, because they were way too big. So what I'm going to do is just drill those out with a very, very fine drill bit, which I've got to get because mine has snapped. Drill those out very carefully and then just file them down. And then put filler along the top of what's left of the windows, just to fill that in. And then when that's done, I can just file all these little square dimples, which were just... And the access door, which was far too deep. I'm going to just file it back so you can just about see it. So when the paint goes on, you can just see it poking through. And that is it for Thunderbird 2 top. Join us again next time on... Ta-da!